Okay, it is Friday, June 18th. It's been like 3 weeks, I know. Been a little busy with both kids' graduations and various things going on in my life. So, just as I said, I will be making videos. All right, I had a lull there, including, getting my teeth fixed, which
Baba Booey
is taking some getting used to, particularly how white they are.
Smoking!
But we'll stain them up with coffee and smoke as quickly as we can so I can feel more like myself. But the most important thing is I can chew now. But some interesting things going on from this neck of the woods. As far as when I last did a video, I talked about my daughter's prom that was put together by parents and people who weren't going for the bullshit at the school with masks and social distancing and all that shit. And I showed you a little clip of it. My son went on to have his dance the same way, no masks, all kind of crowd surfing and fun going on with the music that he ended up kind of being the initiator of. And then their graduations, both of theirs. Going off, as I said, without mask enforcement and all this stuff. But what's interesting is seeing how many people aren't wearing them. You know, some goofballs are walking around in them, but for the most part, so many people are not. And of course, the way they have it is, you know, if you've had the miracle jab, you don't have to wear it. And, you know, since they really can't at this point yet, because of HIPAA laws, start asking people, which that will all change, as you can see coming in around the world, the COVID passes. But for the most part, people are just being told at work and at various places, you know. Can't ask you, so, you know, no, they're not required for whatever. You know, no one's going to bother you. So most people, of course, around here aren't wearing them down here in South Jersey. Now, that's not true in many places. I do know that. But here, it's been kind of nice, little lull, which is part of the take, PSYOP that we're in the middle of. So we're in a small little give part as the summer rolls in. Memorial Day weekend was hot as fucking balls.
It's like Africa hot.
Even though it's been in the 70s for the entirety of the spring and even now, you know, today. For about a week and a half to 2 weeks there, it was about 95 degrees and oppressive heat and all over the weekend. First it rained, you know, they had to rain the weekend out. Then it went to oppressive heat. And then everybody started coughing everywhere, including myself. So that's what happens when weather changes so drastically. And now everybody's feeling better. We're back to beautiful weather for the moment. No spray and garbage in the sky. Breeze. And people walking around. I would say in the stores it's about half and half wearing the face muzzle. But at places, you know, like I said, I've attended the graduations. My kids have been to graduation parties, their friends, pictures, out to dinners and all this kind of crap. No one's wearing them, including the workers at the restaurants. One of my favorite Italian restaurants in the area, if you ever come down here, is Joe Italiano's Maplewood on Route 40, past Hamilton Township, around Mays Landing, I guess that would be. I don't know what's considered. The best, you know. Nobody wearing them anywhere. Inside, working there. Same in all the restaurants pretty much around here. You'll see some of the younger generation with a mask on working at a place, but for the most part, nope. So, little tomfoolery going on, little trickery, little relaxation mode before the variant. I mean, again, as you see around the world, you know, that's not happening in other places. In like the UK, they were supposed to be, you know, relaxed on the 21st of June coming up. That has been postponed for a month. We have to wait a month. It's just too dangerous, you know. And of course, places like Australia and Canada are just fucking hell. Cops beating the fuck out of people. Insane, you know. Germany as well. And to think that's not going to come here. People are crazy. You see, because again, the way this is rolling out, all part of the plan. The give and take aspects of the way they're doing things, all part of the plan. The way they have to do things a little differently here now with the race war they want and the division they want, because of the citizenry having firearms still. All part of the plan. And around the world, the way they're bringing it in. All part of the plan. However, in many ways, people are also coming together, waking up, having rallies, speaking out, and saying no, which is not part of the plan.
Now, when you made such a fool of yourself pretending to be a nun.
That was part of the plan.
When you went to work for Gary.
Part of the plan.
And when you told Gary that the time of the contest had changed.
All part of the plan.
Hey, guys. I'm ready for the real contest, not part of the plan.
You know, so we have various aspects going on, you know. In the crypto world, we have the privacy coins, we have the surveillance coins, we have the, you know, separation of those two things, really not being known by people, people that are looking at the Bitcoin aspect and the Fedcoin aspect is this money-making opportunity to make dollar bills, which are on their way out to being destroyed, as we know, hyperinflated in time as they continue to print, and just pull that money out of the debt market, put it in the stock market, and there's really no money velocity, and supply chain is disrupted the way it is, and, you know, when all of that kicks back in, all hell will break loose, but that will be when they decide, because that's all part of the plan.
All part of the plan.
Good old Woody. And the other aspect of having privacy coins, where, you know, having fungible money that is transferable privately, like you have now, if you want to buy your neighbor's couch for $50. Of course, in many ways, you know, being taken away already, this electronic world, but, you know, looking to be taken away permanently, bringing in surveillance and tracking, and really the allowance to participate in that system as time goes on with the requirements going to be COVID passes and proofs of vaccines and mask wearing and not speaking out and all that lovely shit that comes along with tyranny that most people are pretending is not happening. So I hope people are spending some time getting themselves together in ways for what it is they're going to bring, this Operation Cyber Polygon, which, again, who knows what and how they're going to do it, but it's pretty obvious what the plan would be to go dark. And just like Event 201 before this pandemic, we have this exercise coming, known as Operation Cyber Polygon, where they will simulate, you know, attacks, and power outages, and a computer, and all these cyber, you know, terrorist acts that will cripple us, and how they will respond, you know. And as we know from various things throughout history, recent history as well, especially going back to 9/11, that these exercises have a tendency to go live. It's a great way to confuse the military, who believe they're partaking in an exercise, and all of a sudden all hell breaks loose. They don't know what's exercise and what's real, and the actual task that they're trying to prevent in this practice run occurs, you know. And since the obvious one of 9/11, the world has changed so dramatically when it comes to the rights and freedoms of people that it has been the go-to to really look and see how this works, because it's the most obvious and in your face. Until, of course, this ridiculous pandemic, which... Sorry, let me step over a body here. Wait a minute. Oh, God, they're everywhere. You know what I mean? They're everywhere. I swear to God, I don't really know a year and a half in when a lot of the things I've been saying a year and a half ago coming true now, such as, you know, this push for the miracle jab, this intrusion on people's rights, this, surveillance hell they want to bring in, and the censorship that's going on all around us. And you talk to people who you talked to a year and a half ago, and you told them, or even 5 years ago, when you didn't have this exact, psychological experiment going on around you, but still we were all saying the same things. How they don't connect, you know? And again, it's because it's purposeful. It's chosen ignorance. Kind of like the meat, if you haven't seen, you know, with the magnets sticking to people's arms, supposedly, who have received, you know, the miracle jabs. There's been a discovery of magnets sticking to meat packaging. And been going around. And I saw it last week. And Jackie kindly sent me a video today on it. And here's a little piece of it.
What's up, guys? I made a room called Chasing Veers. And I wanted to show you, I watched this raw meat video a second ago. And I came in the kitchen, and I was like, well, shit, let me try it. And I've been putting a magnet all over our meat. And the hamburger meat didn't do it, but the chicken meat definitely did it. I wiped it off with a paper towel. Look, here's a brand new paper towel. Wiping everything off, right? Chicken juice is dropping out of there. Nothing fake, look. It's all wiped off, right? Inverted, vertical. Okay, look, I'll even put it halfway on the label. It's a little less right through the paper. And again, they're just putting little prions in here. But it's enough to get to our brain to affect us. So watch, I did it this way too. Just to show you guys, putting another bag over it. So you're like, well, it's just a bag, right? Obviously off of it, it's not gonna stick. There it is. Now it's the second layer, I get it, but that shouldn't be possible. You think that's normal? I don't think that's normal, y'all.
And when you look at that and you think, my God, you know, it's coming from every angle. I said that to someone about checking our meat. I said to my wife, I'm not going to have to, it's obvious. And she said, I don't think I want to know, you know. And of course, she's being facetious, but the reality of it is, you know, a lot of people wouldn't want to know, you know, because they think ignorance is bliss. And ignorance is what's gotten us here. And knowing certain things, you can take preventative action, like not fucking eating it, you know what I mean? As opposed to worrying about what we've already eaten, you know, we can, and that's what my wife went by that, like, oh Christ, how much of this have we fucking eaten? She doesn't want to know, you know, I understand what she's saying, but I'm just taking it a step further into how most people really probably won't check, you know, I'll be checking, the reality of it is, everything that we make and buy from here on out, because knowing, as they said, growing up in the cartoons is half the battle.
Remember, it's better to tell the truth.
And that's no lie. Now we know.
And knowing is half the battle. G.I. Joe!
And it is only half the battle. The other half is doing, taking that knowledge and putting it into action and taking, you know, precautions when necessary, making the right choices based on what you know to be truth or, you know, potentially something you need to know. So looking into it and researching it for yourself, then coming to your conclusion and then reacting appropriately. Because that common sense is scared out of people when they're stuck in fear mode, when they're in survival mode. Getting chewed up. Got chewed up as hell coming through with all the spiders earlier getting back here. So that'll be fun. But that survival mode that people live in, that we've been put in, really, through the indoctrination system and the illusion of scarcity, as these fuck nuts buy everything, own everything, distribute everything, even more and more by the day. And we go, there's a shortage. I don't know what the fuck's going on. I don't know, man. I don't know what's going on. It's so crazy, you know what I'm saying? I had someone say that to me, like, well, I don't know, why is lumber so expensive? Why is, well, look at what the fuck's going on. And understand that this is a purposeful shutdown of things. And then it will make fucking sense, you know. People don't want to do that because, again, that's much scarier than some pandemic that they believe they can put on a mask, get a miracle jab, do what they're told, social distance. They got people looking out for them, and they got people studying and putting out this information to keep them safe and censoring all shit that's gonna affect people that will change the direction of the world into a place of uncertainty and unsafety,
I didn't understand what you said.
Unsafe conditions, I should say. Unsafety. Unsafe conditions for them that they're happy to silence those other people and just pretend that people are making this safe path for them and that they're just going to walk it. Don't want to know shit else more. Because knowing shit else more means having to react to the damn truth of the fact that not only is this all bullshit, but that what they're telling themselves is the biggest fucking lie they could tell themselves, because it makes no goddamn sense. Anything that they've said, you know, throughout this whole thing, take what they say and apply it to your life. There are many reasons for you to look and see that the numbers given and the deaths that go on every year, especially in the older population, have a correlation, not to mention the disappearance of the flu stats and the test being used, having discrepancies within that. We can go on and on and on. And the reality of it is people don't want to go down those roads. Because having people in charge of the world with the military and police at their fingertips and the ability to enforce violence in order for you to coerce you to do things you do not want to do with the threat of violence or incarceration as a result for saying no scares the fuck out of people, you know. When the reality of it is those same people being used to enforce it are all victimizing themselves and their family by taking part, and that those who are afraid to say no and stand in it are the reasons why this is allowed to happen. Because the numbers of people in the world that are growing, that realize this is bullshit and are speaking out, are still small compared to the numbers of people that are either ignoring or buying all this shit. And until that switches into a majority of people or a cascade of people starting to say no and not accepting it in their institutions and their grocery stores and their, contingency of what they say or think or post, bugs everywhere, having to be, censored or held back or even condemned by others.
Defoked!
As that occurs all around everyone. And they play into it more and more and more. And they start to throw the propaganda out, you know, as far as whose fault this is that it won't go away. And they start to pit the masked against the unmasked, the vaccinated against the unvaccinated, the, you know, various racial and political divisions they're going to throw in there. The, you know, group condemnation that is going to be utilized, just as they do in Marxism, by the way, to bring about division and chaos that they can then steer and step in as the savior of, is all up to us. All up to us fucking falling for this shit. Falling for the banana in the tailpipe. Not realizing that strange things are afoot at the Circle K. We're giving a shit, really. Just pretending to go about our lives as if it's going to go away. And a big part of this lull here we're having, as much as I'm enjoying seeing, you know, people not wearing this shit, because I'm wearing this shit, you know. but it's nice to kind of be places where you're not surrounded by it. It's just a distraction, really, from the preparation of what is to come. And people don't want to realize that it does go that deep, and it does, you know. But that's too scary. And again, because most people don't know themselves and don't spend the time to get past their analytical lives and their trip around the Monopoly board that they think is so important. Gotta get past Go, gotta collect that 200, gotta own Boardwalk and Park Place. And in the end, once I own Boardwalk and Park Place, I will be happy. You will own nothing and be happy is where you're going. Really. However, people fall for the illusion because that is what we're indoctrinated to believe. And most people that get there find the emptiness along the way come to fruition. The emptiness of achieving that is the missing of all of life before that. The family outings, the, you know, whatever was going on in other people's lives that people worked and worked and worked and worked for. The valedictorian at my daughter's graduation gave a speech talking about how all he wanted to be was valedictorian, and all the time he took studying that took away from his family life and friends and parties. And in the end, when he got it, he said he was on a high for a few days. It was a pretty good speech, actually. Some of these fucking kids are smart, you know. And he said as a few days went by, that high kind of wore off, and he didn't really understand. Again, a summation of the achievement of life, of getting that next stage, from that starter house to the next house, from that promotion to the boss, to that boss to the... And they get all the way up the line. It's the same thing. He's just realized it young. He started to realize his emptiness, he said in his speech, was the missing of experiences that he'll never get back, that came and went, that he didn't go to, whether it was a family dinner or a party with friends or a concert or whatever it had been, because this kid's been wanting to be valedictorian since seventh fucking grade, he's admitted in his speech. And he said all of a sudden it felt empty because of what he missed along the way that he could never get back. So he went on to explain, you know, to balance it and to still achieve your goals, but make sure you balance those things. And I would take it a step further to really look at what those goals are and to see what that really means to be. I'm the valedictorian. Oh, okay, that's fucking great, dude. That means you can go be a doctor and be gone 20 hours a day while you're missing your kids' foundation or your kids', you know, formative years and partaking in the shaping and growing of your child into a good person because you're busy telling yourself, well, I'm a doctor and I'm saving the world. I'm doing it for my son and this is how I'm making money, and making money is how I'm putting food on the table and that's my job, as opposed to being home and being there for your child during those years, because that's where that mindset can lead if you don't stop to realize the experiences you'll never get back. And I thought it was a good speech, and I think it's a good thing to end on here so I don't ramble on. but there's some hope in this upcoming generation. My daughters and my sons, you know, they're 4 years apart. And in both of them, there's a lot of rebellion when it comes to not just going against authority, but when it comes to standing and doing the right thing. And, you know, one other quick story that I'll share. My daughter got some award and she had to go to school, which, you know, both my kids have not been there because they won't wear masks and they've been over the computer to finish. So she had to go to school and they made her put this fucking mask on. She fucking hated it. And she stood, she was saying, because she doesn't wear it. And she stood waiting until she got past the one person that was going to grab her. And they called her name and she ripped that fucking thing off her face, walked out and took on, took her thing and shook hands with the people. And a couple of the people that I knew that were in the audience said to my wife, it was unbelievable. It was, they were so proud of her and it's just the way she did it. And that's what a rebel actually is, not one who just goes against government because it's government or goes against the rules because there's rules. You know, there are rules that exist around us, inherent to this world. And they all formulate around the understanding of morality, knowing what is right, not causing harm to another, not initiating harm to another, while also retaining the right to defend yourself from someone who's initiating harm against you. These aspects of ourselves have been turned over to other people or forgotten about or indoctrinated out of us through fear. And standing up for what is right, irregardless of the consequences, knowing it, that you are right and not worrying about it, is what people need to do. And these younger kids are the target. It's these young kids, especially younger than my kids, believe me. I've followed around some school buses lately on my way home places, and the amount of little kids getting off those damn buses with those muzzles on, they don't take them off, they leave them on. 4, 5, 6 years old, it's horrific, man. This is very dark, you know. If we don't get involved and speak out and try to, you know, do our best to do the right thing in the moment so other people can see it, we're going to head down this path of hell, because you can see really how easy it is already to get where they've gotten. Yeah, there's resistance, but how much resistance even now of those resisting will resist when everything's taken away from them, you know? You have to be ready to dismiss and get rid of all the things that you think you need, because these are the things they're gonna try to take away from you to make you say, oh, I can't, I gotta have my money, I gotta have my job, I gotta have my house, so I gotta do, doing it for my kids. You're gonna find these reasons. That's what they want you to do, you know? But the reality of it is, when you throw those consequences away in your mind and you know you're doing the right thing, what is right, just, moral, and true, and you're standing in that, and all that stuff means nothing, they don't own you anymore, you know? What are we going to do when that happens? I don't know. We'll figure it the fuck out. If there's enough of us, of course. And if there isn't, we'll figure it the fuck out anyway. But just allowing this to continue and going on, doing what you're told, hoping it's going to go away. I hope you know by now, after a year and a half, that ain't happening, you know? And wouldn't you know it, here's the deer we just come across. How beautiful it is. Pretty cool. Anyway, so again, we'll close out again and just say, if you haven't heard, the new Pirate Chain theme song came out last week. Sea, and the name of the ship was Privacy. The winds blew hard and fear dipped down. Blow me, crypto boys, blow. Soon may the Pirate Chain come to bring us crypto golden rum. One day when the system is done, we'll take our treasure and go. I'm going to use that when I talk about Pirate Chain. Instead of getting a copyright notice every time I use the fucking Pirates of the Caribbean. But those are the privacy coins you should be looking at, you know, Pirate Chain and Monero and things like that, to combat these Fed coins, these surveillance coins. You got to try to keep something when the system comes down. And then, of course, turning that into more intrinsic possessions such as food, water, shelter, you know, solar powered electricity, things like that. The things you should be doing now, because that part is coming. And I don't know about you, I don't want to be standing in those fucking lines waiting like it was in the fucking Depression, because they're going that route. And if you don't realize they are, Again, you're kidding yourself. When? Oh, I don't know. Is it tomorrow? Is it next month? It's when they fucking decide to do it. And right now they're printing money galore and they have no plans right now to stop. So you have time to start getting ready still. And the littlest things can help. You never really know what you need until you have it when you need it. You're like, oh shit, glad I have that, you know? So kind of think of those things. Instead of worrying about, you know, what, you know, presidents are doing and this group and that group and, you know, pay attention to what's going on. And also, by the way, have some fun. If it's opened up around you like it has around me, like, I'm going to go and see a fucking Phillies game because you can go in there now without a mask. Oh, you sell out. How about fuck you? I enjoy watching baseball once in a while, and I'm going to go enjoy that experience potentially for the last time in my life, which I've already written off. I did enjoy for the last time in my life because I wasn't going to go back in masks or vaccines or COVID passes. So for the moment, while they're giving us this little lull, I'm going to scoop my family up, and I'm going to go sit in the sun and watch a fucking baseball game. You know? Sue me. And I'm going to try to catch a fucking concert, too. A good one. While I can. I would suggest doing some things that you enjoy. This is but a game. This is the illusion. As long as you're not selling your soul to these things, you're allowed to enjoy things. People need to get out of that mindset that they have to be sitting in a Indian cross style meditative fucking, you know, state every day. And, you know, enjoy life. That way you know what the hell you're actually standing up for, you know. Do the things you enjoy. Climb a mountain, go hiking, go camping, go fishing. Do something, you know. Because otherwise, what the fuck are you fighting for? What is the future you're trying to save for your children if you're not enjoying the things that they're trying to take away? Anyway, love you guys. Get learning, get speaking.